It all comes back to money.
This is the Keeping Your Money Show with Jamie Westenberger and Bart Steindler.
All right, welcome back to the Keeping Your Money Show. Jamie Westenberger joined, as always, by Bart Steindler. If you've been listening the whole time, or maybe you just tuned in, we've been talking about fees that could cost you over $350,000 during your lifetime. Paying for your grown kids' rent and vacation, probably want to cut that out. We talked about how our priorities are a little messed up right now. How to answer this question will determine how well you live in retirement. If you miss any part of that, or you want to listen to it again, or maybe you want to share it with somebody, you can find it on our website. Go to keepingyourmoney.com. You can also find it on our podcast partners, iTunes, Google Play Music, SoundCloud, YouTube, and Stitcher. Also, if you ever want a segment emailed to you, you can't find it or something, shoot us an email, info@keepingyourmoney.com, and say, hey, I was listening on August 12th, and you guys were talking about this, and I want to share that with somebody. We'll happily email it over to you. So, scams.
They never end.
The Social Security Administration recently issued a warning about an upsurge in schemes that target Social Security recipients. They basically are calling, saying they're with Social Security, your benefits are screwed up, they need to verify some information, or you will not get next month's check. Right?
Mm-hmm. They don't generally work that way.
No. But the sad thing is, you know, if somebody's living on Social Security, that's pretty scary to not, you know, potentially not get your information or your money. So many times they fall victim to this. And I think a lot of times, we were talking at the beginning of the show, you know, technology, while we love it, as you get older, it becomes more difficult, more complicated.
It actually becomes a tool that can be weaponized against you.
Exactly, because since you don't understand it, you know, my grandma, you know, love her to death, bless her heart, she's in her 80s, she's a wonderful woman, she's recently been trying the whole phone, and she even does email every once in a while, and she called me the one day, and she still has dial-up, so so she disconnected from the internet to give me a call, She said, do you know anyone that does virus removal? And I said, like on your computer? And she said, yeah. And I go, well, why? And she goes, well, I just found out I have a virus. And I said, well, how did you find that out? And she says, well, this person called me, you know, to let me know that they had been monitoring my computer and I have a virus, you know. And I said, well, that person has no way to monitor your computer. That's a scam, you know.
Yeah.
But, I mean, she doesn't understand the technology because, you know, it's not something she was raised with. So it seems like a viable situation that someone would be monitoring her network and knows that she has this.
I know of a case where it became such a problem that people were being scammed. An elderly person was being scammed over her computer that her children decided that it was time to just remove the computer. Like at some point you have this conversation with your parents if they continue to drive and they can't see that you take the car keys away. Well, sometimes you have to take the computer away. You know, sometimes you have to just sit down and explain things to them that, you know, you can do this, but you can't do this, and that these are the different scams that are happening. And it's a conversation you kind of have to have with them repeatedly, because as you get older, sometimes your memory is not quite as good as it used to be. And you may have been told 2 or 3 months ago that this is a situation you have to be aware of, but you could be have totally forgotten that by the time it actually happens.
So something, now they give some points if you're contacted by the Social Security Administration. Number one, hang up. They would not call you. They will provide you something in the mail if they need you. Never provide your information over the phone to anybody. It says with unknown caller ID. I don't care if it says Social Security Administration on the caller ID, hang up, look them up in the phone book or online, call them back at their main office. You know, don't ever provide. Same thing with your credit cards. You know, they call about this stuff all the time. We're calling about your credit card. Can you verify the last four digits of it? I don't know. You're calling me.
Yeah.
I'm not verifying anything with you.
Right.
You
know? Right.
And then they say report it to the Social Security Administration. Something that we have done for elderly members of our family, and I've recommended this to some clients too, and by all means use it if you think it's helpful, but we actually created like a... Now, we all know that many of our older family members have a phone. Most of them don't have cell phones. If they do, they're very basic ones. But, you know, I know my wife's grandparents still had the phone that was mounted on the wall with the really long cord, mm-hmm. you know. Mm-hmm. So there's usually a centralized area in a senior citizen's home where the phone is being answered. And one thing that I've seen helpful is to actually make like a laminate sheet that says, if someone I don't know is calling, and then kind of lists out the steps of how to handle it. Because like you said, it's not one of those things now where someone has to remember, now shoot, was it Social Security Administration that was scamming people? Or was that Medicare? Or was it the VA? Or was it, you know, it doesn't matter.
Or the Internal Revenue Service.
Right. What matters is, one, do I know this person? No. Two, if I don't know this person, hang up.
Right.
you know what I mean? I mean, like any government agency that wants to get a hold of you will mail you something in the mail.
Right.
Very, 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 very infrequently will they call you. And even if they do call you and you hang up on them, they will send you something in the mail. So right. You're not in danger of losing your Social Security benefits or, you know, not getting your tax refund or anything like that simply because you refuse to talk to them on the phone.
You can always look up that agency's number and call them back.
If you really want to. Yep.
The other thing, too, is they'll ask you a question that you will answer yes to. And a lot of times what they're trying to do is get a recording of your voice saying yes. And that way they can apply for different types of things under your name over the phone, and when they ask for verification, they got that recording of you saying yes. Mm-hmm. So that, you know, don't say yes to them.
Or they'll just get you on the phone talking a lot.
Right.
Because if you can take a couple minute phone conversation with somebody, as crazy as it sounds, you can actually turn that into just about anything.
I mean, how many times have you seen it where, you know, some comedian takes a recording of somebody and moves all the words around and things yep. like that to make it into something funny?
Yep.
Well, a scam artist can do the same thing. Mm-hmm. So don't let them record your voice. Don't have a lot of dialogue with them. Just as soon as the thing starts and it's not anybody you know, say,
yep.
just hang it up. Don't say anything.
You know, a perfect
just hang up the phone.
A perfect example of using somebody's words. You know, do you remember back when Howard Dean was running for president?
Oh, yeah.
And he actually won in Iowa. And mm-hmm. he had that whole rant where he was like, and we're going to Indiana. And we're going, you know.
He starts screaming. And
so there was a radio show. And I don't remember which one it was now. It could have been like Howard Stern or someone mm-hmm. like that. But they actually called Delta at the time to make airline reservations. And they called and they said, hi, I'm Mr. Dean's personal assistant. We're calling to make airline reservations. We're really excited. It looks like we're on our way to the presidency, yeah. you know? And the lady was like, sure, I can help you with that. He goes, well, I'm just going to put Mr. Dean on now. And it was like, we're going to Indiana. And she's like, we're at in Indiana, sir. And he goes, yeah, and then Wisconsin. And she's like, sir, I need to know where in Indiana. Woo! You know? and she's having a conversation with a recording,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
But I mean, it was funny to listen to, but the flip side is that could be used in very nefarious ways as well that would not be, you know, in your best interest. So always good to keep an eye on that. Keep an eye on those things for our elderly loved ones as well. All right, coming up, we're going to wrap up the show, send you into the weekend right here on the Keeping Your Money Show.
It's never too late to plan for your future. And the Keeping Your Money Show can help. Our team of advisors can answer questions you may have about investing your money. Through Securities America, Inc., our advisors offer a diversified and comprehensive list of quality products and services. Call the Keeping Your Money Show at 1-888-98-MONEY or visit keepingyourmoney.com to schedule your free consultation.
Kylin Law provides clients with the clarity and confidence they expect from attorneys that live and work in the evolving business world and your community. As the owners of Michigan-based businesses, our attorneys bring insight and real-world experience to the firm. Kylin Law is your resource for estate planning, helping your family with effective strategies and solutions. Kylan Law. Your business, your estate, your law firm. Contact us at 855-453-4536 or at kylanlaw.com.
This is the Keeping Your Money Show with Jamie Westenberger and Bart Steindler.
All right, welcome back to Keep Your Money Show. Jamie Westenberger joined, as always, by Bart Steindler. If you're just tuning in, getting ready to listen to the next show, come back an hour earlier. You missed all the good stuff. We talked about fees that could eat up more than $350,000 over your lifetime, why paying for your grown kids' rent and vacation could be a bad idea. That still shocks me. $500 billion a year to grown children, $250 billion a year to your own saving for retirement. I think I know why we have a retirement savings problem in this country.
Yeah, that's part of it.
We also discussed how answering this one question will actually determine potentially how well you will be in retirement. And then we discussed scams. Social Security reports an uptick in scams right now targeting our most vulnerable, our elderly population, and unfortunately being quite successful in scaring them about their benefits and then acquiring a bunch of information from them that they, of course, use for terrible things. I want to remind you, if you missed any part of the show, you can find it on our website. Go to keepingyourmoney.com. You can also find it on all of our podcast partners, iTunes, Google Play Music, SoundCloud, YouTube, and Stitcher. Just search for the Keeping Your Money Show. If you'd like to contact us, set up an appointment. First consultation is always free. We don't charge anything, and there's, of course, no obligation. If you want to come in and start getting an idea of how you can design an income plan for your retirement, we would be happy to help you with that. Our toll-free number is 888-98-MONEY. That's 888-986-6639. Again, we'd love to sit down and help you figure out how to get a plan for your income distribution when it comes time for you to retire. So, another great show in the books, Bart.
Absolutely. It's a prerequisite. Like when you go to college and you take Econ 202, The prerequisite is Econ 201. The prerequisite for watching college football on Saturday is listening to the Keeping Your Money show at 9 o'clock.
And the only way you can test out of it is if you come in and let us sit down and do an analysis of you, and we'll let you know if you don't have to listen anymore.
Right.
All right. Well, I'm going to tell you like I tell you every week. You'd never go on a trip. You'd never go somewhere for vacation or spring break or Christmas or one of the holidays without putting some kind of plan in place. At a minimum, you'd know how you're going to get there. You also probably need to know how much it's going to cost, what route you were going to take, what things you need to bring with you. The same is true for retirement. So many times we think of it as a destination, but in reality, it's just the beginning of a whole nother journey that could last you 30, 40, even 50 years. And if you're not planning properly for it, if you don't have a roadmap for your retirement, if you don't have an income distribution strategy, how on earth do you think that's going to turn out well? Let us give you a hand. Give us a call, 888-986-6639. Let us help you put together that distribution strategy for your retirement income. For everyone here at the Keeping Your Money Show, Dan Van Singel, Shane Thorson, Nate Boonstra, Troy Fox on the Lakeshore, our wonderful producer, Laura Ridenour, my compadre, Bart Steindler. I'm Jamie Westenbarger. Thanks for listening. Have a fantastic weekend. Go Blue.
Registered representatives offer securities through Securities America, Inc., member FINRA, SIPC. Financial advisors offer advisory services through Securities America Advisors, Inc. Forest Hills Financial, Inc. and Securities America are separate entities.